Hi and a very warm welcome to all of you. A very good evening to everyone. I hope you all are healthy, safe and fine, right? Take care of your health and your family's health, especially when the exam is around the corner. You have to be very, very cautious because the cases are still rising, right? So avoid going out, stay indoors, work hard, prepare hard. All right, do check out our crash course for RBI grade B exam. All right. You can watch Sir's videos, right? You only have 45 to 40 days left for the exam. You can make it or break it, all right? So get a detailed strategy. No, this is the right time to, you know, start solving mocks, right? You know, start focusing on areas that can maximize your score more and more, all right? So do download our preparation app, or if you can get all the exam updates, right? And monthly GK, all the important PDFs and exam notifications, everything will be available on the app. All right, it will save a lot of your time. So you can definitely download it from Google Play Store. And if you want the PDF for our daily current affairs videos, do join our Telegram channel, the link of which will be given in the description below, right? Not only the PDF for all the daily current affair videos, but also, you know, quant and reasoning ke important and helpful study materials and all the notifications regarding live updates and videos, everything will be shared on our Telegram channel also. So you can just join that. Okay, so let's move on. Let's start with today's session with the very first question. Which state government has signed an MOU with Ministry of Commerce in Thailand to promote trade and investment? All right, state government can also sign MOUs with foreign countries, right, with foreign ministries and portfolios to promote trade and investment. Many Indian states have done that, like Kerala and Gujarat and, you know, even Maharashtra. But right now you have options: Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Karnataka, Assam and Himachal Pradesh. All right, you have to answer the correct. The options are also very, very interesting, right? The most tempting options can be Assam or Arunachal Pradesh because it's Thailand, but let me give you a hint, it's not so. It is one of these three states: Tamil Nadu, Kerala or Karnataka. All right, so the correct answer here is actually not Tamil Nadu, sorry, Telangana. The state government, the MCQ, there is a slight mistake in the MCQ. It will get corrected and rectified at the soonest possible level, all right? The correct answer here is Telangana. The state government of Telangana has come into an MOU with the Ministry of Commerce in Thailand to promote trade and investments, right? The purpose is to enhance the cooperation of small and medium enterprises and startups, right, through business and incubator innovation system. So basically, startups and MSMEs ko promote karne ke liye ek MOU sign kiya hai, the state government, between the state government of Telangana and that of Thailand. All right, innovation system T Hub, the government of Telangana in partnership with many private players has launched this initiative named T Hub. T-Hub basically is a collaboration, a platform, right, to promote startups and innovation, startups and people who are, innovating new things and, you know, forming a startup to commercialize new innovations. T-Hub platform has been launched by the government of Telangana. The chief minister of Telangana, you should know, K. Chandrasekhar Rao, all right, K. Chandrasekhar Rao. और ग्लोबल लिंकर बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट एंड इंटरेस्टिंग इनिशिएटिव है एंड ये भी तेलंगाना स्टेट का है. ऑलराइट, सो अंडर ग्लोबल इनिशिएटिव इज बेसिकली अ प्लेटफॉर्म दैट इंक्लूड्स ऑल द स्मॉल एंड मीडियम एंटरप्राइजेस, राइट, टू हेल्प देम कनेक्ट ग्लोबली, राइट. ग्लोबल कनेक्शन के की बेनिफिट्स क्या हो सकते हैं? टेक्नोलॉजी ट्रांसफर, राइट, पीपल टू पीपल कॉन्टैक्ट, learning of skills and innovation techniques and even management systems. So exposing small and medium enterprises to international business practices and new technologies is the key benefit of such MOUs, all right? So this is the key issue here. Yeah, and Thai trade is also an initiative of Thailand government. All right, a similar initiative by Thailand government to promote startups and business ventures. So this is a very important trade and investment MOU. And as I told you before, Jumpy, hum log, I hope you all know the capital of Thailand, right? It is quite expected of you all. Okay, so basically my motive is that whenever we come across any news of related to a state government, we should also cover some national parks, key national parks and wildlife sanctuary. Why? Because there is at least one question on national park in the RBI grade B general awareness questions. All right, so never miss out on that, right? It will hardly take an extra 1 minute or so, right? These are very popular. So some important national parks is Mrugwani National Park in Telangana, right? You have Mahavir Harina National Park and Kaval Tiger Reserve. Kaval Tiger Reserve is very, very important, right? Main important reserve in Telangana. Why? Because it also keeps repeating itself in news time and again, and it can be probably asked in the exam. You never know. So why leave any stone unturned? That's the key idea over here. Alright, so moving on to the next question. We have, which of the following states have signed Combined Reciprocal Common Transport Agreement? CRCTA, Combined Reciprocal Common Transport Agreement. Kaun se state ya fir following states ne sign kiya hai? Of course, ye ek agreement hai, toh any single state will not be the correct answer. Right? Ye bahut hi ek logical si baat I'm telling you. If such a question comes that which of the following state has signed an agreement and no other state is mentioned in the question itself, then obviously the answer will be all of the above, right? Why? Because Delhi or Haryana will not sign an agreement with itself. Okay, obviously another state will be involved, right? So it would have been more tricky if options would have been like A and B or A and C, all right? But aisa nahi hai. Isme ek hi option diya hua hai that involves more than two states, and that is all of the above. The obvious choice is all of the above. Okay, so factual knowledge is important for this exam, but also you have some scope of using your common sense to eliminate the options. Jahan pe use ho raha hai, please apply your mind. Okay, so combined reciprocal common transport system basically kya hai? As the name suggests, it is a reciprocal agreement, right? Agar ek transport system, ek state government allow kar rahi hai, toh same type of allowances, right, and permissions will be given by the other state government. Alright, so basically, let's have a look at what it is. The correct answer, you all know, Delhi, Haryana, UP and Rajasthan, these are all NCR states, right? NCR states hain ye, Delhi, Haryana, UP and Rajasthan, jo ki combined reciprocal common transport agreement they have signed together. All right, so CRCTA ensures seamless movement of passenger vehicles. Seamless movement of passenger vehicles in the North Capital Region. Or in North Capital Region, mein passenger vehicles related to education institutes, right, they will be given a permission to transport seamlessly. How will they be given the permission? Road taxes se sabse pehle inko exclude kar diya jayega. They will be exempted from all the taxes as well as the road track taxes. All right, there will be a countersigning, right, a countersigning of permits and licenses. Right, countersigning means all the licenses will be applicable in one single state authority. So for example, there is a vehicle that is licensed by Haryana Road Transport Corporation, then it won't need any similar license or a copy if it is traveling to Delhi. All right, it will already be countersigned. So this is one of the key provisions that allows seamless flow of passenger vehicles. Remember, it is only applicable to passenger vehicles, not cargo, not goods, passenger vehicles. All right, so isme a common criteria is that the age of the vehicle should not be older than 10 years, right? The minimum, the maximum age of the vehicle is 10 years, right? 10 saal se purani vehicles ke upar ye agreement applicable nahi hoga. right? A single point of taxation, exemption from road taxes, right? All these services, all these provisions are there in this CRCTA agreement, right? So basically a NCR regional policy development, right? Regional policy of NCR to 2021, ek launch hua tha in 2021. It is a part, this agreement is a part of that regional policy of NCR development. Alright. So this was all to it. Right? It has come in effect, in immediate effect, and all educational institution and stage carriage buses of state transport of NCR participating states are covered. NCR participating states kaun kaun sa? Very very obvious, like Delhi, Haryana, UP and Rajasthan. Theek hai na? Now moving on to the next question we have. Which state has announced to celebrate April 14, which is the birth anniversary of Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar ji, as Equality Day? Alright, kaun sa state ne April 14th ko as Equality Day celebrate karne ka announcement kiya hai? You have options Telangana, Tamil Nadu, MP, Maharashtra and Gujarat. Alright. Answer the question very very quickly. The options are really nice, right? Bahut sare log confuse ho sakte hain Maharashtra. Why? Because sabse important Dr. Ambedkar ne bahut hi important movement launch kiya tha in March 1927, which is the Mahad movement, right? That dealt with oppression of the outcasts, right? And Dalit, right? They were restricted to use public places and, you know, public water bodies. And their restriction on temple entry, all these issues were dealt with. Sabse pehla social empower movement, right? Not sabse pehla, but sabse important social empower movement was carried out under the leadership of Dr. Ambedkar, that is Mahad movement in March in Maharashtra. Alright, but the correct answer here is Tamil Nadu, right? Tamil Nadu has declared April 14 as the birth anniversary of Equality Day. Let's have a look at the details. April 14th, Tamil Nadu will be celebrated as Equality Day. Another important part is that E.V. Ramaswamy Naikar was a very, very important politician in South India, right? E.V. Ramaswamy Naikar was revered as, or respectfully known as, Periyar, right? Periyar, he launched self-respect movement. Self-respect movement launch kiya tha inhone, and that also dealt with oppression of the lower castes. Alright, same issues as Dr. Ambedkar's movement, right? And his birthday, that is 17th September, it is celebrated as Social Justice Day. Alright, so these were some important details. Okay, it is a very important Dravidian movement. His birthday is celebrated as Social Justice Day. Alright, 20th March. Isse bahut hi important and related news hai. I'm talking about Maharashtra. Right? Not Maharashtra, but all over India I'm talking about. 20th March is known as Social Empowerment Day in India. Right? Social Empowerment Day is celebrated on 20th March in India. Alright. This is on account of the anniversary of Mahad movement or Mahar movement, right? Or also known as Mahar Satyagraha, which was carried out by Dr. Ambedkar, right? Because we are talking about Equality Day, right? We are talking about Social Justice Day. So we should obviously know about Social Empowerment Day, which is celebrated on 20th March, the anniversary of Mahar Satyagraha. Remember that. Okay, so moving on to the next question, what do we have here? Which country's army officials will be given training under phase 2 flying training on Chetak helicopter? So if you have been following the news, right, if you have been following defense related news, you would be knowing that phase 1 of Chetak helicopter training was given to Nigeria, right? It was given to Nigeria. And that has been extended to phase 2, right? It is expected to be concluded by December 2022, right? Nigerian army or aviation officers will be given flying training under Chetak helicopter, jo ki India ke aeronautics and defense related organization, public sector undertaking, HAL ne French government se, you know, license leke commission karwaya hai Chetak helicopter. It is a lightweight utility helicopter, right? And Nigerian aviation officers will be trained to fly under it. Alright, so Hindustan Aeronautics Limited has signed a contract with Nigerian Army. Phase 1 bhi was done with Nigerian Army only, right? Chetak helicopter mein flying training di jayegi unko. It is a continuation of phase 1 as I discussed earlier, alright? And this will also be executed. This is expected to be executed in December 2022. Right, 70 hours of flying training will be imparted to each of the Nigerian. Nigeria, you all should know, it is a very important nation in West Africa, right? This is the map of Africa. So, West Africa mein Nigeria ek bahut hi important nation hai. Let's not do the maps, right? West Africa mein very important nation Nigeria, its capital is Abuja, right? And president of Nigeria is Muhammad Buhari, currency is Naira. These are some minor facts that you should know, right? So HAL, let's quickly revise some important facts related to HAL, right? First, let me write down these points. Capital of Nigeria is Abuja, the currency is Naira. Okay, and president, you all know, Mr. Muhammad Buhari. Alright, so HAL, let's revise HAL. We have also discussed about HAL in one of our previous videos. In fact, in many of our previous videos, but let's just go through the facts once again. Right, HAL is a public sector undertaking. It is the world's largest aeronautics defense manufacturer. It works for the government of India. A board of directors are appointed by the president via the Ministry of Defense, right? So these are some important facts about HAL. HAL ke headquarters kahan hai? These are in Bangalore, right? HAL headquarters are in Bangalore, and right, and the current MD and chairman of HAL is Mr. R. Madhavan, right? Mr. R. Madhavan is the current MD and chairman of HAL. All right. So, moving on to the next question we have, which IIT has partnered with NTPC to design and develop a highly efficient plant for CO2 capture for power plants? Like a smog tower, which was recently established in Delhi a few years ago, right? In Connaught Place, a smog tower was established, right? Basically, Tata Power Project ne smog tower established kiya tha in collaboration with IIT Delhi, IIT Madras and IIT Bombay. Alright, this time it is a high energy efficient CO2 capture power plant. This power plant is an energy efficient. Why? Because it has been developed on a very large scale, right? So to the running the operating cost of running this power plant in terms of energy makes it a highly energy efficient power plant that will capture CO2 from power plants, right? CO2 capture plant, actually it is known as CO2 capture plant, and it will capture the emissions from power plants. So basically, power plant se sabse important emission kya hai jo ki bahut zyada pollution create karta hai, so short run mein bhi visible pollution, that is flue gas. Flue gas is one of the most harmful pollutants from thermal power plants, and flue gas contains carbon dioxide as well. So basically, flue gas mein carbon dioxide ko capture karega this energy efficient power plant. And which IIT has partnered with NTPC? Answer the question correctly first. IIT Bombay and Delhi, you all know, it has already developed a smog tower in Delhi. Maybe we will discuss about more details about it in one of our videos, but let's just focus here on this question. The correct answer here is IIT Guwahati has partnered with National Thermal Power Corporation to set up this CO2 capture plant, right? Iska patent bhi they will apply for the patent of this technology because it is an indigenous technology, means it has been developed in India, right, by a research team led by Professor Bishnu Panda Mandal. Okay, so these are some facts about it. Of course, what will it do? इसमें थर्मल पावर प्लांट की जो एनर्जी एफिशिएंसी है इट विल बी इम्प्रूव्ड. व्हाई? बिकॉज थर्मल पावर प्लांट्स प्रोड्यूस अ लॉट ऑफ पोल्यूशंस, सो उनमें पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल मेजर्स भी अप्लाई होते हैं. दे हैव टू फॉलो सर्टेन प्रैक्टिसेस, रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस. सो इफ दिस CO2 कैप्चर प्लांट इज सेट अप नियर थर्मल एनर्जी प्लांट्स, सो इन अ वे इट विल हेल्प देम टू इम्प्रूव देयर एफिशिएंसी एंड वर्क इन अ बेटर वे. Alright, so that is very important. And also if pollution level is controlled with the help of these CO2 capture plants, then it will also help India reduce its carbon emission and at the same time use its thermal power capacity to its full potential, right? At the same time, it will use its thermal power capacity to the full potential. It will help India towards achieving its sustainable development goals. Okay, so moving on to the next question, we have: which bank has announced to buy 75% stake in India International Bank, Malaysia? Right, which bank has announced to buy 75% stake in India International Bank? India International Bank ne mein kaun sa bank ne 75% stake kharida hai? Right, you have options. Indian International Bank, basically it is a consortium of bank. It is a partnership of several banks. We will discuss more about it. But first, answer the question. The correct answer here is Union Bank of India has proposed to buy 70, has announced that it has bought 75% stake in IIB Malaysia, right? That after this purchase, Union Bank of India actually owns 100% stake in India International Bank, Malaysia. All right. 100, it makes it 100% UBI unit, but initially India International Bank of Malaysia ke original promoters of the bank were Bank of Baroda, Indian Overseas Bank, and of course the remaining state was also owned by Andhra Bank, right? It was incorporated in the year 2011. It is a localized bank in Malaysia. It uses its banking networks with London, Hong Kong, Singapore, right, to improve its networking and, you know, develop a global connection so that it can give its customers a range of financial solution and tailor-made financial needs. All right. So basically, it is a financial service provider bank. All right. First, iske promoters were Bank of Baroda, Indian Overseas and Andhra Bank, and now it is 100% unit of UBI Bank, that is Union Bank of India. Alright, so that was it to this question. Moving on to the next very important question: which bank has signed an MOU with GIFT Special Economic Zone to promote global and Indian businesses, right? Which bank has signed a memorandum of understanding with GIFT City? तो आप सबको पता ही होगा, in गांधीनगर गुजरात. All right, it has signed an MOU with GIFT City's Special Economic Zone unit to promote global and Indian businesses in the Special Economic Zone of GIFT City. Right, remember GIFT City is a very very huge financial technology infrastructure setup, and Special Economic Zone is just a part of it. Right, it contains a lot of other provisions, a lot of other small infrastructures. We will discuss more about it, but first answer the question. The correct answer here is ICICI Bank has signed an MOU with GIFT City, all right, to promote global and Indian businesses, right? It jointly works to attract global investors and capital market firms, right, to set up operations in GIFT City, Gujarat. MD and CEO of GIFT City is Mr. Tapan Ray. ICICI Bank chairman is Mr. Girish Chandra Chaturvedi. Right, and CEO is Mr. Sandeep Bakshi. Headquarters kahan hai ICICI Bank ke? Write it down in the comments below. Where is the ICICI Bank currently headquartered? ICICI Bank is correctly headquartered in the city of Vadodara in Gujarat. ठीक है. MD and CEO is Mr. Tapan Ray of Gift City. Let's have a look at what this Gift City basically is all about. Gift City, why it is known as city? First of all, it is known as a city because it's a central business district that runs between Ahmedabad and Gandhinagar and Gujarat, right? It has a lot of infrastructure capacities, right? It promotes a lot of businesses, especially financial technology businesses. It has a special economic zone. It has an international technology park, all right? That is Software Technology Parks of India. STPIs are also situated in Gift Cities. All right, it has shopping malls, stock exchanges. So basically, it promotes international finances and finance technology. All right, so it is very, very important. You should know a bit more about it. Okay, moving on to the next question we have. Punjab National Bank has celebrated its foundation day on April 12th. When was Punjab National Bank established? So it is a fact-based question. April 12th is the foundation day of Punjab National Bank, and it is asking you when was the bank established, right? So answer the question correctly. The bank was first established in the year 1894. Right, 1894, it was founded by Lala. It was co-founded. It was most importantly, it was co-founded by Lala Lajpat Rai and Dayal Singh Mathija. Right, Dayal Singh Mathija. Both of these people are founders of Punjab National Bank, right? Its headquarters are in Delhi. MD and CEO of Punjab National Bank, Mr. Atul Kumar Goyal. And also recently, we read an RBI report, jisme sabse zyada banking frauds bhi Punjab National Bank mein hua hai. You should know about it. By volume, the highest number of banking frauds, right, in a span of 13 years has been witnessed by Punjab National Bank alone. The second highest bank was Bank of India, but that's another news. April 12th is the foundation day of Punjab National Bank. All right, it was co-founded by Lala Lajpat Rai and Dayal Singh Mathija. Lala Lajpat Rai, you all know, he was a great freedom fighter and author and a very important politician. Along with Punjab National Bank, he also founded Lakshmi Insurance Company, right? Lakshmi Insurance Company was also founded by Lala Lajpat Rai ji in 1894. Okay, so these are some facts. Now we have moving on to the next question. Who has been appointed as the new chairman of National Accreditation Board of Hospitals and Healthcare Providers? So National Accreditation Board for Hospitals and Healthcare Providers comes under the Quality Council of India. All right, Quality Council of India, a very important public-private initiative hai that was set up in the year 1997 by the then Department of Industry, which is now known as Department for Promotion of Internal Trade and Investment. All right, so answer the question first so that we can move on to the explanation. The correct answer here is Mr. Mahesh Verma has been appointed as the new chairman of National Accreditation Board for Hospitals and Healthcare Providers, right? He is the Vice Chancellor of Guru Gobind Singh IP University, right? So it is a constituent body of the Quality Council of India, right? And it focuses on accreditation, certification, right? And quality approvals of all the healthcares and hospitals. So yes, we were discussing about Quality Council of India. So ye public private partnership hai, 1997 mein launch kiya gaya tha, and it is actually modeled on the National Accreditation Board of the Netherlands, right? Netherlands ke National Accreditation Board pe isko model kiya gaya hai. It provides a range of services, right? Kaun kaun si services ye provide karta hai? Number one, it provides accreditation services, right? Accreditation services means authentication services, right? Services for quality of healthcare, right? Healthcare ho gaya, insurance ho gaya. Healthcare, insurance, even institutes and professionals. Institutes and professionals. quality promotion and quality assessment. All these services are provided by Quality Council of India all over India. All right. It is a public-private partnership. Always remember, ये government organization नहीं है. Quality Council of India, it is an autonomous organization. And जितने भी autonomous organizations हमारी country में set up किए जाते हैं with the government body and in collaboration with some private players, right? These autonomous organizations are generally registered under the Societies Registration Act. राइट सोसाइटीज रजिस्ट्रेशन एक्ट में इनको रजिस्टर किया जाता है. ऑलराइट, सो करंट चेयरपर्सन ऑफ क्वालिटी काउंसिल ऑफ इंडिया इज मिस्टर अदिल जैनुल भाई. राइट, मिस्टर अदिल जैनुल भाई इज द करंट चेयर ऑफ क्वालिटी काउंसिल ऑफ इंडिया एंड जनरल सेक्रेटरी इज डॉक्टर रवि पी सिंह. राइट, इट इज एन ऑटोनॉमस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड क्वालिटी काउंसिल ऑफ इंडिया के की प्रमोटर्स कौन है इसको भी आप नोट डाउन कर लीजिए. इट इज quite important. It can definitely probably be asked in the exam, right? ASSOCHAM, FICCI and CII, right? These are some key promoters of Quality Council of India. Okay, so moving on to the very last but another very important question for the day is, which Indian city has been classified as 2021 Tree City of the World for the first time? For the very first time, a city has been classified as Tree City of the World, and that is Hyderabad. Hyderabad has been classified as the first Tree City of the World. It has been classified as Tree City of the World along with Mumbai. Right, both Hyderabad and Mumbai for the first time. The correct answer here is Mumbai. Mumbai for the first time has been classified as the Tree City of the World. In 2020, Hyderabad was the first Indian city to come under this category. Right, Hyderabad has won this position for the second time. For the first time it is Mumbai, for the second time it is Hyderabad. Aise yaad kar lijiye aap log. मुंबई एंड हैदराबाद को जॉइंटली रिकग्नाइज किया गया. इट इज़ ट्री सिटी ऑफ द वर्ल्ड इट इज़ अ रिकग्निशन गिवन बाय द फूड एंड एग्रीकल्चर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स एंड द आर्बर डे. मुंबई हैज़ मेड द लिस्ट फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम एंड हैदराबाद हैज़ बीन फीचर्ड फॉर द सेकेंड कंसेक्यूटिव ईयर. ओके, सो दीज आर सम important facts. Hyderabad basically क्यों आया है, तो Telangana government का बहुत ही important initiative है, Harita Haram. I don't know how to pronounce it, you just remember the spellings, right? It is a important initiative by the Telangana government to improve greenery in the city. Alright, that is why it has been probably won this title for the second time. Alright, and Arbor Day Foundation, ek non-profit organization, right? It is headquartered in Nebraska, the United States. Alright, John Rosno founded this organization in 1972. And basically, Arbor Day is an NPO that is dedicated to planting and afforestation activities. Right, planting of trees and afforestation. All right, so this was it for today. I hope the session was useful to you. To get access to the PDF, join our Telegram channel. The PDF will be shared over there. All right, you keep asking this question and again in the comments below. Right, you will find the PDF in the Telegram channel. So please go ahead and join it. Thank you so much for watching the video. Take care and see you in the next class.